Captain's Log Stardate 0201.19. Our goal was to create the ultimate fifth grader. Stay tuned to see how we're going to do it. Fifth grade, the final frontier. These are the voyages of the Starship Enterprise, its one-year mission to explore math, science, reading, and writing concepts, to participate in incredible gaming adventures, to boldly go where no fifth grader has gone before.
Sir, I can't raise them. M5 is still blocking all frequencies.
In math, we sought to multiply a whole number by a fraction. The lessons can be found in the S'more version of Mr. McCoy's weekly log. In reading, we delved into a short biography about Charles Goodyear, featuring his inventions with rubber. Comprehension strategies were utilized as students worked in teams to read about how inventors changed the world, featuring streetcars and horseless carriages. The Wright Brothers, and Inventions and Industry. We also learned about the efforts of F.E. and F.O. Stanley and their steam-powered automobile, and in conjunction with our study of invertebrates, student researched unhuggables about nature's most unloved creatures. In writing, we also discussed that when researchers prepare a draft, they take stock in all the information that they have and conduct quick research to tie up any loose ends. And informational writers take a moment to look back over their research and conjure an image of what they hope to create, sometimes by quickly sketching a new outline and then writing fast and furious to draft fresh versions of their report. In social studies, objective, identify how new industries changed the United States in the late 1800s. This led to our study of the rise of big business, such as oil, steel, and railroads. We also delved into a byproduct of this era, child labor and sweatshops. And in science, we focused on invertebrates with an opportunity to compare and contrast ant and termite colonies. You might want to ask your child about our own ant colony on board the USS Enterprise. And we looked into the nests of termites and ants. Our focus then shifted toward plants as students learned about hydroponics, leading them toward a study of photosynthesis via an investigation, carbon dioxide, featuring Alodea plants. They also worked to identify the function of plant substructures and examine how these plant substructures help plants get what they need to grow. The Unit 21 spelling test is coming this Friday, February 1st. For all of the words for the entire school year, be sure you access the S'more version. Also, the further adventures of Will Page and Shades of Grey come to a conclusion at the end of this week. The links to those read-alouds can be found in the S'more version. And now, here comes this week's best bit. They do not have to like it. Your expected standards of behavior do not have to be approved by the child. They do not have to like the response you choose to his or her behavior or the choices that you give him or her. Your child must be free to feel whatever he or she is feeling. However, your child simply cannot be permitted to do whatever he or she wants. More best bits are coming in future editions of Mr. McCoy's Weekly Log.
There's got to be a way of getting to the M5. There's got to be a way.
Motivating your fifth grader. There must be a way. And there is. There's an article that features motivating your fifth grader. It talks about how motivating your fifth grader helps with his or her learning. It suggests that you play trivia games with your child. Download educational programs that your child can use. You can also refer to my Google site. There's all kinds of educational links there. And let your kid research your next vacation. Instead of you planning everything, have your child plan the budget, plan the destination, create the itinerary. All kinds of skills come into play. The full text of that article can be found in the S'more version.
Thanks.
fantastic machine, the M5. No off switch.
Captain, what is it?
These controls are locked. We can't disengage the computer.
Why can't you stop fidgeting and focus on your homework? Have you ever asked your child that question? I have asked questions very similar to that on board the USS Enterprise. This article, Keeping Your Child Focused, has suggestions for how to achieve that focus during times to work on homework. The first suggestion is create an ambiance that is conducive to focus. That involves playing soft, instrumental background music and turn off the harsh lighting. It should be soft lighting, no fluorescent light bulbs, that kind of thing. The second suggestion says turn off devices. Kids are mesmerized by their devices, but when they are mesmerized, they aren't focusing on what they need to focus on. And the third suggestion is have reachable materials nearby. I've talked about this before. Every supply your child needs to do homework should be close at hand, because when your child gets up to track down a pencil or a piece of paper, he or she wastes valuable time. The full text of that article can be found in the S'more version. As you know, your child has begun a research project. There is a link in this week's edition called Westward Expansion Through Maps. It can help your child with his or her research, so please direct your child toward that website. Also, our Valentine party is coming up on Thursday, February 14. It will run from approximately 2:10 to 2:40. We will spend part of our Valentine party time distributing Valentines. Your child is not required to make a Valentine, but if he or she chooses to participate, a Valentine needs to be made for each member of our class. Now, the class list can be found in your child's Friday folder. I've also included a copy in the S'more version of Mr. McCoy's weekly log. Your child can bring the Valentines in a decorative box that he or she makes at home. If he or she doesn't have such a thing, I have sacks that your child may use. Valentine party coming up on Thursday, February 14th. Liberty Oaks Market for Charity Day is coming on Friday, February 8th, beginning at 1:30. You're invited to attend. Unbridled Adventure awaits us in issue number 24, entitled Bread and Fifth Graders, of Mr. McCoy's weekly log. It will be delivered to you for the week ending Friday, February 8, 2019. Be sure you join us.